Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to talk about controllers in JMeter. So basically, what is logic controller? So logic controller let you handle the order of processing samplers or requests in a thread. So logic controllers will decide when and how to send a request to a web server. So JMeter provides a different type of logical controllers. So like critical section controller, for each controller, if controller, include controller, and so on. So first of all, we'll start discussing one by one. So first I will discuss today in this video, basically loop controller. So what is loop controller? So loop controller makes the user request run a specified number of times or run forever. So let me show you practically. So let's go to JMeter. So currently I have a small test plan. So I'm just going to create a few threads. So go to create a thread group, and currently I have number of thread is one, threads are one, and ramp up period is one, and loop count is also one. So under this thread group, I'll just make some sampler request, multiple requests I'll make here. So I'll just say HTTP request. So here I'm going to hit my website. So here multiple pages I'm going to hit. So the first one is this one. Let me copy this one. So we have to remove this one, put www. And this path we have to include in this particular path variable. So this is one request we'll do in index page. And I'll say this is HTTP request, or I can say simply index page. And after that, I'll create one more request. So I'm just copying this. And I'll create one more request here. Let's paste it over here. And here, instead of index page, I can this time I'll just ping the about page. So this is about page. Let's go to JMeter and then I'll change the about page. And I'll say this is a about page. Save it. And I'll say one more request. So here I'll just go to another page, that is our contact page. So copy this one. And here the another request is this is contact page. And this is your contact.html page, right? So now I have just created, I have hit the request in two different pages in my website, index page, about page, and the contact page. So currently there is only one user in the group will be executed all three. So I will also add one listener to see the report, view results in tree. So finally save the plan and let's execute this. And once we started execution, now we can see all three requests have successfully done, index page, about page, and contact page. Now here my requirement is, so currently I have a three request, right, HTTP request under one thread group. So if you want to execute all of them, right, multiple times, so I can just say thread group user count threads we can increase. Suppose number of users, when I say three here, or so three users means for three users we'll send these three requests. So what I can do is there is a loop count here, right? So when I say here for three, for example, now what happens, or when I say two here, what happens is these three requests will execute two times. So first round and second round. Similarly, when I say five here, these requests will execute five times. Index will execute five times, about will execute five times, contact page will execute five times. So this loop count is applicable to all the sampler requests which are comes under thread group. So basically this is applicable for all the thread groups. Suppose when I say here, let's say two here, okay? So when I give two is a loop count. Now save this. When I execute this plan, close this, clear this, and execute this. Once I have executed, now we can see requests I have sent in two times. So index page, about page, contact page, again index page, about page, contact page. So three times executed, three requests. Now my requirement here is I want to execute specific request multiple times. So I want to execute only index page three times, but rest of them I'm not. So how we can control this? So I want to execute index page three times or five times, but about page, contact page, I want to execute only one time. But if we specify the loop count at the thread level here, this is applicable to all the requests. So how we can make it possible is through loop control. So we can just add a loop control to the thread and we can control it. So I'll again make it as a one. So I want to execute only index page three times. So just go to thread group, right click here, add. Now here you can see logic controller. So under logic controller, you can see loop controller. So let's go to loop controller. Insert this loop controller. Now here you need to specify how many times you have to execute that particular index page. Suppose I want to execute index page 5 times, right? So now after specifying this, just put this index page under this particular loop control. Make that as a child request under loop control. Okay, so now I'll just make it as above. So fine. So under thread group, we have a loop controller. Under this index pages comes under. So index page only will repeat 5 times because we specified that under loop controller, and rest of them will execute only one time. Now let's execute, save it, clear the result and execute, then see the results. Now when I see here, index page is executed 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times, and about page, contact page is executed only 2 times, only one time. So this is how we can just use loop controller. Now, for example, in the thread group level also, I specified some loop count. Let us say here, 2 I specified. Okay, in our loop count level, I say specified 2. So now what happens? So whatever time I specified at the thread level, loop count will applicable for all the requests, even including in the loop control. So now what happens is, first round, it will capture 2 writes. So loop controller, it will enter here. Under loop controller, index page is there. So loop controller, index page, internally again saying 5 times, right? So 5 times will execute, then page and contact page. And again, it will go back. And second time, again, loop controller will execute second time. And index page will execute 5 times. And about page will execute 1 time. Contact page execute 1 time. So what we need to understand here is this loop controller will execute multiple times, depends on the number of loop count we specified in the thread level. So in the loop controller, again, we have a one more request which will execute 5 times. So totally how many times index page will execute? Here controller, we specified 5 times, and thread group, we specified 2 times, and 2 into 5, 10 times will index page will execute. Okay. Now let's clean this result and execute. Now let's see the index page. Now when I see here, how many times executed is index page? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times executed. And again, rest of the request, about page, contact page, these are not part of loop controller, so these are executed only 2 times, and the thread group time is 2, so that is applicable to about page and contact page. So about page and contact page is executed 2 times here. All right, so this is how, if you want to execute specific request multiple times, only that particular request, and then we can just use loop controller. This is a usage of loop controller, guys. Okay, so we can execute single request multiple times, specific request multiple times. All right, suppose if you want to add this particular result tree or controller level, so it will capture only the result of this one index page into this particular tree. So for example, let me just move to this loop controller. So now the result tree is also part of loop controller, right? So now let's execute. So let me just save it, clear this and execute now. So this result tree listener report is part of loop controller. So it will capture the result only of index page, not the rest of two. So let's execute. So now we can see it contains only index page because this we created under loop controller, not at the thread level or plan level. All right. So if I create this loop, this particular report or listener inside this loop controller, only the request which are comes under the loop control will be logged here. Or if I specify this one under thread level, all the requests which are comes under thread group will be logged. Okay. So this is how we can use loop controller. In the next video, we will see rest of the loop control, rest of the logic controllers. So thanks for watching.